Hello everyone, today's our topic class 7 history lesson 2 new kings and kingdoms part 2. The main kingdoms of south. The main kingdoms here were the Rashtrakutas, the Chalukyas, the Hoysalas, the Kakatiyas, the Cholas, the Pandyas, the Cheras, the Pallavas here. Rashtrakutas. The Rashtrakutas ruled over large parts of southern, central and northern India between the 8th and 10th centuries CE. The Rashtrakutas came to power under the leadership of Dandidurga. Dandidurga defeated the Chalukyas of Badami in 753 CE, present-day Karnataka. The Gujaras of Malwa, and he went on to capture Kalinga, Kosala and Srishailam. Krishna I, 756-774 CE. Krishna I succeeded Dandidurga. He built Kailashnath temple at Ellora during his rule. This is believed to be the most elaborate rock cut monument in the world. Dhruvadhara Varsha, 780 CE. Later Rashtrakuta ruler Dhruvadhara Varsha defeated the Palas, the Gujara Pratiharas and annexed Kanauj. Pataliputra was a leading city of North India, but Kanauj replaced Pataliputra because the ruler of Kanauj had access to fertile Indo-Gangetic plains. Amogha Varsha 1. In the 9th century CE, Amoghavarsha I established his capital at Manyakheta, which remained the capital of the Rashtrakutas till the end of the empire. He was an accomplished scholar, writing in both Kannada and Sanskrit. He wrote the poem Kaviraja Maga in Kannada. Rashtrakutas ruled over for 200 years. Rashtrakutas was broken by the Chalukyas of Kalyan. The Cholas. Cholas were powerful ruling dynasty of South India between the 1st and 3rd centuries CE. After going into decline for some centuries, they rose again in the second half of the 9th century CE as one of the most brilliant dynasties of Indian history. For the next 400 years, the Cholas held sway over South India. This period refers to as the classical age of South Indian history. Credit for paving the way for a glorious Chola rule goes to Rajaraja Chola and his son Rajendra Chola. These two great monarchs gave political unity to South India for the first time. Rajaraja Chola, 985-1014 CE. Rajaraja Chola followed a policy of war and conquest. He defeated the eastern Chalukyas of Vengi, the Pandyas, the Gangas of Kalingas and the Cheras of Kerala. He captured large tracts of the Deccan and even parts of Ceylon. Rajaraja introduced two important features of the Chola administration, the navy, local self-government. He laid the foundation of a powerful Chola navy. In 1005 CE, he appointed his son Rajendra Chola as his successor. Rajendra Chola, 1014-1044 CE. Rajendra Chola carried Chola power to greater heights. He captured Vengi, sent a naval fleet into the Bay of Bengal and took over parts of Sumatra, Malaya and the Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Rajendra Chola undertook an expedition to North India around 1023 CE, defeated Mahipala of the Pala dynasty and annexed Bihar, Odisha and Bengal. Gangaikondan. As a mark of his victorious campaign, he is said to have carried water from the Ganga to his new capital Gangaikonda Cholapuram. He also annexed the title of Gangaikonda, that is, conqueror of Ganga. Rajendra Chola's defeat of the Sri Vijaya Kingdom, the present-day island of Sumatra, this is in Indonesia. Sumatra is in Indonesia, made the rulers of the southeastern island kingdom keen to have friendly relationship with him. It is said that King Surya Varman, one of Cambodia, sent a chariot as a present to Rajendra Chola. By the 13th century CE, Chola power was once more on the decline. The Pandyas defeated the Cholas and rose to power. The fall of the Cholas was aided by invasions of the Delhi Sultanate in 1310 CE and the rise of the Vijayanagara Empire in Karnataka. Special features of the Chola government. First, we will learn about the administration. Rajaraja built up Chola power with his clever administrative skills. Under him, the Cholas perfected a highly organized administrative system with a strong center. But the autonomy of village assemblies was also protected and nurtured. At the top of the structure was the king, who held all power. The entire kingdom was divided into two categories: areas governed by vassal chiefs, areas directly under the king. Areas directly under the king divided into six provinces or mandalams. The provinces were divided into districts or nadus, which were further divided into kurams or kottams. Local self-government. The Chola Empire had a very efficient system of local self-government. Village administration was carried on by the village assemblies called urs. A group of union of villages called a kurram or kottams managed its affairs through sabhas or mahasabhas. The mahasabha consisted of learned Brahmins who were gifted land by the rulers. They had extensive powers. But the sabhas were still under the control of the royal officers called adhikaris. Elections were held every year by casting votes. The sabhas had different communities to look after different activities. Members of these committees were picked by lords. There were 8 committees to deal with various aspects of administration, that is, gardens, irrigation, cultivation, education, land, roads, judicial and accounts. Each village had a treasury of its own and accounts were maintained meticulously. Irrigation. The Cholas developed an extensive and well-planned irrigation system. Rocky hollows were used to make artificial lakes, and embankments were built for them. Dams were built across the Kaveri, like the Kalanai in Tanjore, to store water for irrigation. Irrigation channels were built that carried water from the rivers and lakes to the fields. Revenue. The main source of revenue was the land. The king took 1/3 of the produce either in cash or in kind, preferably the latter. The land was surveyed and categorized according to yield. The officers were strict in the collection of revenue, but the kings made every effort to to help the farmers increase the yield. The other taxes include professional tax and those on trade, forests, mines, irrigation, and salt. State expenditure was mainly on maintaining the rulers and their families, on building palaces and temples, on maintaining the army and navy, and public welfare works like building roads and dams. Army and Navy. The Cholas developed powerful army and navy. Army consisted of infantry, cavalry, and elephants. The best horses were imported from Arabia. A huge amount of money was spent for the maintaining and upkeep of the army. The Cholas were the first to maintain a large and efficient navy. The Cholas' navy was one of the strongest aspects of the Cholas' empire. Thank you.